The Polynesian Cultural Center is a 42-acre living museum dedicated to the preservation of Polynesian cultures. Visitors from around the world come to participate in the activities and enjoy the world-famous Polynesian review, Horizons. Now you can bring this excitement home to enjoy year-round with family and friends with our collection of videos, audio cassettes, compact discs, and souvenir books of your experiences here at the Polynesian Cultural Center. To order, simply call 1-800-283-3108 and speak to our sales representatives. You can also receive a free catalog of all our products. Do it today and receive the joy and excitement of Polynesia year-round.
The Pacific Ocean is larger than all the dry land of the world put together. I am a Polynesian. In the heart of this vastness is my home. Polynesia is an immense triangle, 12 million square miles, bound by Hawai'i in the north, New Zealand in the south, and Easter Island on the east. It was the voyaging canoe that brought us. It was the canoe that carried our culture to 10,000 scattered islands. We came from the east, we came from the west, and the ocean became our common highway. From the koa wood of Hawai'i to the great green stone we found beyond the glaciers of New Zealand, we shaped our tools and our lives. The film you're about to see is the story of the Polynesian Odyssey. It is not the story of one man, or one family, or one time. It is a story told in symbols, like the chants and legends that linger on the lips of the very old and are then passed on. It is a story of feelings and facts, and it cannot be otherwise, for it is said, you cannot understand Polynesia with your head. You must understand it and feel it in your heart.
We came from the west.
We stepped across the isles of the sea.
We sailed from the east.
We were driven before the winds.
The sea became our highway.
Our beginnings are lost in time.
We are Polynesians.
We are many.
We are one.
The great void, and afterwards Te Po, the dark. Tane Mahuta, son of Papa Tuanuku, forced earth and sky apart, and life began in Te Ao, the world of light. Legend says the Polynesians emerged from a hole in the earth and have always been upon the islands of the sea. But the traditions long whispered on the lips of the very old tell of long voyages of ancestors in the ancient homeland. But even the oldest of the legends do not recall the beginning. It is but a shadow on a lost page of history. 12 centuries before the birth of Christ.
Mm-hmm.
these first courageous Vikings of the sunrise. What was in their heart as the vision of the long white cloud called them from the distant horizon? They traveled left with the rising sun. The moon and the stars showed them the way. The terrible deep became the bosom of their gods and realms of the ancestors gone before. Became their home. Strange winds became their friends. The sky covered them. Waves and currents whispered to them. Winged creatures bid them follow. And they remembered. To a destiny that lies beyond reason. The fire of life that burns in the human heart is kindled by curiosity and carried by courage. We're driven by fear and sustained by faith. Progression. We pass in a moment and are gone, but mankind remains. The voyagers of the ancient Pacific were unknown to the world, and the world was unknown to them.
Yeah.
did they venture forth on their baffling odyssey? By what power did they move upon these waters? Ancient Polynesians is cast in monuments of stone that stand as solemn guardians to mysteries that cannot be solved and secrets that will never be discovered. Born in their minds and living in their hearts. It was the voyagers themselves who set the bounds of Polynesia. Wherever they ventured, they made the physical world a part of their spiritual universe. From heaven and let them fall into the tropic sea. Set sail upon the open sea, the Polynesian had discovered every inhabitable island in the awesome isolation of the South Pacific. Their extraordinary odyssey stands unique among the greatest achievements of man. The memory of the Odyssey remains alive. It is etched on the mind of the very young and passed father to son, generation to generation, forever.
Thank you.
I will tell you the story of Tafai, a great hero of Tahiti. And I will tell you of his marriage to Hina. Hina came from the island beyond the sunrise. Her hair was the color of the black coral, and her skin was soft as the flesh of a young coconut. The ancestors wanted to go to the wedding of Hina and Tafai. The venerated spirits of the ancestors were one with nature and her gods and did not want to miss so fine an occasion.
Hey, ho, ho, ho.
was that Hina and Tafai were married. Their love was deep and lasting. Tafai launched his great and magical canoe and sailed away. Coconut will grow, the coral will spread, and man will cease. But the Polynesians did not cease. They persevered, they increased, they survived. Were governed by mana. Mana was power, the power that let them survive. Mana was their character, their status, their strength and good fortune. It was mana that powered their universe. It was mana that flowed from God to man.
Thank you.
home. The sea isolated and protected them for 3 millennia. But the Odyssey of Polynesia would not end.
Welcome to paradise.
Paradise, we've changed forever.
Changed, sir?
Yes, lad. Maybe for good, maybe for evil. It'll never be the same. May God judge us kindly.
Thank you.
There are old ways and new ways. Some things have changed, and some things will forever remain the same. For all things are spiritual, and all things are part of a consciousness that never ends. Into life and our departure from it poses profound questions and presents perplexing mysteries. The questions and the mysteries of our own lives are vivid in the migration of the Polynesians. Coming and going, the arrival and departure, birth, death, creation, and ultimately the quest towards an endless life. Remain. The quest continues, and the Odyssey is never ending. We'll be right back.